Hey guys, so today we are going to be reviewing Glossier. So I have a in-store order. As you can see, I got my name on it and I got the packaging still here. I stopped by the store in New York in the beginning of June and I've been waiting to do this review because one of my products were missing. So I have everything now. I'm very excited to show you guys. I got it all in my box of goodies, aka the recording box. And today we're basically gonna do like a wear test brand review. Got my little lopsided retro pony thing going on. It's hair wash day. Perfect day for me to try out Glossier because I ain't really trying to do too much, and that's kind of what this brand is about. A little quick overview of the brand. This brand was created with skin in mind. They say skin first, makeup second, and just skin is in. Those are a bunch of their slogans. So generally everything is supposed to take care of your skin. We have a mix of skincare and light makeup. First thing would be cleansing the skin, and this is their Milky Jelly Cleanser, and I've been using it for the whole month of June. I'm about down to right here. This has been my daily cleanser. I've been switching this out with another product recently, but it's a really nice basic cleanser. It doesn't feel like it's stripping your face, but it doesn't give you a super deep clean. This is the full size, so this is $18, and they also have a smaller size that's $9, and this is what I've already rinsed my face with, so my face is ready for the next step. And this would be either when I would try out their sunscreen. If I'm, you know, gonna go out, I would put the sunscreen on. I'm not going to put this on right now because I wanna do a separate video on this, but this is something I will give a quick little, you know, overview of. So it's an invisible sunscreen. It's called the Invisible Shield. It's clear. And I've also been using an invisible sunscreen from the brand Supergoop from Sephora as well, and I'm gonna do a versus video with them. This isn't a bad sunscreen, it's pretty affordable. It's about $25 and it has a really nifty pump, very easy to just throw in your bag, and I just take this with me to the pool for the kids, for myself, etc. But because I am going to put on the makeup, I'm gonna use this little sample of their primer that came with my order. So this is what the primer looks like. It's about $22, it's their priming moisturizer. So it says, after cleansing, massage in upward strokes, up and out, dollops of the cream into your face, add additional layers to prime skin for a desired effect for makeup or for life, since it's not required to wear makeup. A lot comes in this sample. But as you guys saw, the moisturizer itself is in a white consistency. It's a little bit thicker than I would usually lean towards because my skin is oily for the most part, and summertime is not doing it any favors. I like to use gel consistency primers or gel consistency moisturizers lately, so it's a little thicker. It's not super thick, not like Vanny cream thick or anything like that, if anyone has tried that, but it is definitely in like a medium level of heavy. It definitely has like a little bit of tackiness. It does say that it's good for morning or night, so you might want to use more or less, it says, but it'll give you a glowing canvas to have your makeup or your skin ready for the day. That was about half of the packet, so there was probably like 3 uses in this sample because I obviously had way too much on my face. But now that our skin is prepped and ready, we're gonna move on to their perfecting skin tint. So this comes in 5 shades, retails for $26, and from what I've seen, it says shake very well, so I'm gonna start doing that. But this is probably the thinnest foundation or skin product or tint I will ever use on my channel, because everyone says that in their reviews, from what it seems, or, you know, blog reviews, video reviews, everything I've seen is that this has a very slight amount of color. So it's really good for those days where you want something but you don't really want something. I've been wearing a skin tint from another brand that is more of a medium coverage. This one I am anticipating that's gonna be very light, and I have this guy on my face. This is not Scott, for those who know who Scott the Scab is. This is a Q-tip marker that I did to myself the other night by accident. So it's very tender right now, and I'm feeling that's still gonna be very apparent, and I have a lot of blackhead extractions going on. My skin has looked better, so I hesitated on filming this video because today is just not a good skin day for me because I've been doing so many videos lately. I need to like really give my skin a break after this video. But I also was thinking, well, this side of my face is pretty normal except for a blackhead or two, and this side is having problems. So I think even though it might make me a little insecure, it's a really great testing canvas for other people because not everyone has perfect skin. So whether you're having a pretty good skin side or a really bad skin side, let's just see how it goes. I have my little foundation disc here so it doesn't get everywhere. I've already shaken it very well, and this is in shade dark. So when I swatched it in store, it's kind of freaking me out. So we got a little on the dish. Yep, very watery. Shake, then smooth over moisturized skin with fingertips. Blend upwards and outwards for sheer cover and instant dewiness. We gotta get messy. Blending very well. I'm glad I picked the shade because medium seemed a little too light for me. And I know the shades are generally pretty forgiving after they blend in. That's why there's not too many of them, because of the consistency of the product. It's basically like skin, like water skin, that just kind of evens out your complexion. So as you can see, I have more uneven on this side, and this side has at least an even coloring. Feels very comparable to like a silicone primer. The mixture of the primer and the actual product itself has like a light filmy type of feel to it. Like, it doesn't feel dry at all, which makes it easy to blend. This is definitely something I could apply on the go if I was like taking a train up to New York or whatever the heck. Like, I could do this and not worry too much about like, oh crap, I forgot my sponge, you know? I don't think a sponge would be great for this product because I think it would absorb very fast. I'm gonna take a little bit more and see if I can add a little color right here. But I think that's as good as we're gonna get. You can see the slight tint on my fingers from the color. Ooh! Now I'm gonna take a smaller, dense kind of round top brush by Smashbox compared to a really big one and just see how it applies with a brush. It's working, but it's also absorbing the product. Because the same amount of product I just picked up was the amount I used on my entire face. So this is a full commitment with your fingers kind of deal. It does the trick. So I think on a normal day, you probably would assume that I'm not really wearing anything on my face because of the finish, which is appealing to a lot of people, so it's not like it has to be my cup of tea. I don't mind this. If my skin was having a really great day, I probably would love it. It has the reflection that natural skin would if you weren't wearing makeup, so that's cool. This would probably last you forever because a little bit does go a long way if you do use your hands. So $26 doesn't seem too bad. So the next product I want to test out is their concealer. So this is the stretch concealer. I got this in shade medium for my under eyes. As you can see, it's kind of lighter than my skin tone. It's even lighter than it shows in the pan. This also comes in 5 shades for $18. And I'm going to take it with a brush just because I want to see how it goes with a brush. All of their products are supposed to be really easy, so you can use your fingertips, and are instructed to use your fingertips. But as you can see, this is a nice color for my under eyes. Depending on the consistency, I told myself, oh, maybe you'll want to get the dark shade for your skin, like, if you like it. But I feel like I just prefer it for my under eyes, because it's a very hydrating concealer. I'm going to pat this in with a sponge. Oh! So much brighter, don't you think? It looks great with this brush sponge combo. I'm sure it blends like a dream with your fingers. Just I do not have the coordination or the patience to pat it in as well or as quickly as this side did, especially near my eyes, because I am the type to poke my eye out real quick. So I'm just gonna set it with some loose powder. I wasn't really feeling their loose powder myself, like just from swatching it in their store, I was like not feeling like the shades were gonna fit me as well as I would like them to, or the finish was what I was looking for. But I'm gonna set that concealer because it's so hydrating, we need it to hang out. And that didn't take any product really at all. Like, this could last you forever. It seems like a little bit goes a long way with the majority of their products, so after thinking about it, I'm trying to kind of dilute how much powder I have out here just because I'm going to try the highlighter stick and I don't want the powder to interfere with that. The rest of my face has dried down and it's not super shiny. It's like a nice satin finish. I would probably want to powder my T-zone, which I'll do right now quickly, just because nothing stands a chance against my T-zone. It's unforgiving. This was the highlighting stick that was somehow left out of my order. I think some mix-up happened in the checkout at the store, so this wasn't in my bag, so I had to order it again. Highlighter in quartz. That is how much product you get. So smaller than the actual container right here. It's actually smaller than I assumed it was gonna be. Well, don't be immature, Sam. So this is what the color looks like swatched. And it's supposed to give kind of like a wet, subtle look, as you can see. Not too much pigment. In my opinion, between their boy brow brows, which we're about to get to, and this highlighter, I think these are like the two most known products from the line. And then their lip balm, like everything becomes like quick favorites for a lot of people. So I'm very worried about swiping this directly on my cheeks, but for video's sake, let's just get in there and try it. I'd like to note that I did heat it up on the back of my hand before I put it directly on my face, but let's see how this goes. I'm so nervous. It's very sticky, like my finger gets stuck to it while I'm tap, tap, tapping. It blends very easily, so I'm not too scared now of just putting more and more. To me, it's a little lighter than I would like it to be as far as being like, oh, it looks like I'm wearing nothing. But I don't mind a booming highlight. But if I was going for the looks like I'm wearing nothing impression for my skin tone. So we're gonna prep the lips because they dry. They busted right now. This is the mintbalm.com, one of the scents or flavors. And they have a couple different ones. There is, I believe, like a coconutty looking vanilla one and some fruity ones. But mint to me was my favorite. Safe bet. It definitely has a like overlay feel to it. It's cooling, it's minty. I like it. I've been using it for the past few days. It's not like my favorite lip balm I've ever used in my life, but it is a good one in my opinion. I'm gonna let that soak into my lips before we move on putting color there. And we're gonna work on our brows in the meantime. So my brows are microbladed and you can see that. We're gonna apply just the boy brow into them, and this is in shade blonde. This combo is good on its own in my opinion from the one time I've used it or with soap beforehand. Soap really gives you a super super fluffy look, but not required. I personally really like this shade. I think it looks a lot like the shade I have microbladed into my brows, and as you can see, it just kind of fluffs them up a little bit. This is my good brow though, that actually grows upwards. The other side does not, so that's like the bad brow that does what it wants. So that's what it looks like if I'm going for like a messier thing. We'll come over here, little gap here, and you could totally apply this and then put a little brow pencil through the spots that you feel like you're lacking. Little areas that kind of make it look like I did my brows a little bit today. I'm just gonna take a clean brush and just wipe around the brow. It makes it a little bit more tamed. For lips, we have the shade Leo from their Generation G products, and this look like a nice brick ready shade. We're just gonna try together so you can see the difference. It gives some warmth, a nice natural shade. This is kind of where we are right now with our makeup. As you can see, my bad side is still living its life over here. I'm just gonna hit these spots with a little additional concealer, and this is by Becca. That's just for my preference. I wanted to give you guys what it looked like without any additional concealing, but I'm just gonna hit my prominent spots with a little medium coverage. This is not full coverage. If I want a full coverage, I'd probably go with the new Too Faced concealer. So as you guys can see, I kind of have like these little like sunspot freckles that a lot of people don't notice, but when I take like selfies without anything on my face, I'll be like, you have freckles? I'm like, kind of, a little bit. And there we go. That is our Glossier, with a little bit of assistance, face. I like what it looks like. I think it looks very composed. And if I didn't have whatever's going on my bad side, I could totally go without any concealer and be like, okay, just a light makeup day. Cool. Like, I felt like doing something, but not really. The last product I have that I cannot put on my face right now, but I will put a clip in for you guys, is the Glossier Mega Greens Galaxy Pack. And this is a mud mask that you let dry on your face for 20 minutes. This one does not dry to the point that your face stiffens or to the point that it feels like itchy, or, you know, some clay mask is hardened to that extreme where you're like, eh, wasn't attractive. I also have a mask that's white, also in the same like tub size. That one's more moisturizing, more for dry skin, and this is more for like combo oily skin. I like it, but I wouldn't repurchase it personally. It didn't do anything too crazy for me. I was hoping for the best, but it is a detoxifying mask, so if you are looking for a mask from them, they do have this. It just didn't, you know, do anything crazy for myself, who owns like 75 different clay masks. There's a very slight amount of flashback, but nothing too crazy, honestly. It's more just like, hey, it's a flash picture. I don't believe any of the products have SPF in it aside from the actual sunscreen itself. So that was our starting point picture, and I will see you guys in a couple hours. Guys, when I tell you it's hot, it is hot today. So it's been about 7 hours, and I wanted to end the wear test because I don't think much will change from this point. So I just went out, ran some errands, got my nails done, pedicure. It's the first time I'm seeing my face in a couple hours, and can you even tell that I just reapplied the lip color whatsoever? I just applied it. But it's very natural. I mean, that's the point. I like the lip color though. I would definitely rewear it. It gives me some color, but it's not too much. It has like a little glide to it, but for the most part, it is not like glossy in texture or anything like that. It has more of like a demi matte finish. Not super drying, but not super hydrating either. As far as the rest of my face goes, it looks pretty good still. Like the color is definitely still there. Still looks very natural and it's been holding up very well. My oils are starting to sink through now, but you can't really tell because it's so natural that you can't tell that the foundation's gone on the end of my nose fully. I think that's a kind of a good thing though. So if you're wearing this for, you know, that natural like skin, I barely did anything today look, if that's what you're going for, it will do it for you. You will probably need to set it like I did, because otherwise I think I'd be missing quite a bit by now because of the temperature, because of my skin type, etc., etc. The highlighter itself definitely is still there. I can see the shine hit when I turn my face. It's very, very subtle in person, to the point that I almost felt like I wasn't wearing highlighter. This is definitely good for those days where, again, I don't know how many times we can say natural. It's almost like a drinking game at this point in this video. It will give you that natural effect. I don't think I would wear the boy brow by myself just because it doesn't do too much for the fact that I already have microbladed brows, but this with some soap brows, it would probably give my hair a little bit more color and texture in combination with the soap. So that's not bad. The concealer itself is not caking up under my eyes, which is nice. It's starting to fade a little bit, but for the most part, I really think this area was brightened very well with the shade of medium. Generation G lipstick dried me out a little bit. I got a little peeling going on, but nothing too crazy. I'm surprised to say that I did like the majority of the things that I tried for what it is. I'm not gonna expect this on a full coverage glam day, but if I just want a little something, if I'm going on some sort of outdoor adventure and I want a little something, I would definitely reach for this stuff again. So generally everything is Samage approved, except possibly the Galaxy Pack, since I don't think I would repurchase that. And for further thoughts on the Invisible Shield, stay tuned. Again, it's not bad. Everything else to me is worth a shot if that's what you're looking for. The Prime Moisturizer wasn't bad. Would I get the full size? Probably not, because I have other primers that I like, but it is great if you need some hydration that also acts like a primer. And it definitely will give you a nice canvas soft texture for your makeup. And I could see myself purchasing the darker shade of concealer for any blemish spots. I didn't wear any bronzer or blush. I feel like that might have also added to just generally the like fresh face look. They do make blushes. I think they might have a bronzer, but I definitely know they make the cloud blushes. But I wasn't personally interested in any of the shades, just generally after swatching them in store. Don't expect too much from the packaging. It's just simple white and pink, like the brand. I think they're trying to keep everything nice and clean, which hopefully keeps the price points on the lower end. It's, to me, it's mid-tier because it's not in drugstore prices for everything, but it's also not super high end either. It's in that like little cusp, like this could be carried at Sephora and fit right in price point wise. For the most part, all of their packaging is plastic except for the stretch concealer and then a few like serum bottles, which I have not tried because they have like hyaluronic serums and like vitamin C serums, which I have a lot of, but a lot of people do like those. So let me know down below what you are going to pick up from Glossier, what you have tried, what you liked, what you did not like, and generally give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Thank you guys as always for watching, and I will see you guys in a later video.